Erica De Vera. My life like before was like, I was pretty active, but I wasn't really focusing on, I wasn't really a health buff. So posture was bad despite being an athlete. Like, I wasn't really focusing on those stuff. And the tendency is to only focus on healing when you have something wrong. It wasn't healing, or it wasn't focusing on health before anything goes wrong.
Hi, I'm Bea. My life back then was like, I'm also active like my sister, but in a different sense. I was more on performing, so I was into dancing, and I danced for a really long time. And back then, what I noticed with myself is that I really overworked my body, and not just because of dancing, but also because of schoolwork and extracurricular activities. I don't really focus so much on healing my body, or like really taking care of my body. For me, taking care of my body is sleeping or getting enough rest. That's it. But like the rest of it, I just really focus on overworking my body. Kaya minsan, I really get a lot of sore pain from my shoulder or my back, and all I can do is like the normal rest.
I don't know what to expect, like what we're gonna do. Well, I've been seeing because I like chiropractor, and I thought it was gonna be like a long cracking session. I didn't know what to expect, but then after that adjustment, I also didn't expect the feeling, like the ache here from your spine adjusting. And I didn't know that short session would have like that long lasting feeling over the week. And yeah, like I didn't know, like just doing that consistently already had a big effect on my spine.
Yeah. For me, I didn't expect what was gonna happen when we were going to adjust us, and also I didn't expect what I would feel after, because It was our first time also, and I only knew the usual chiropractic videos, and I was kind of surprised, because even if it was just super fast, I felt something different. Like, I just felt something different with my body. And ever since then, parang mas naging motivated ako to make sure I have a good posture, or make sure I'm doing things right at home, because it feels good to actually take care of your body, and I wanted to continue that consistently.
I find myself in situations where my posture is good, and so I just realize like, oh, I'm like in this posture now. And I didn't even force myself to go in that way. And I feel like everything feels like, all the movements feel smoother. Like, slouching gives me pain, and I didn't realize that it was because of my bad posture. And also, like, I don't really seem to have like any headaches or like any sort of like pain that I used to have before on a regular basis. Awesome. So it's much better right now.
So my life now, because of this whole process, I guess I became more aware of what my body feels, because before I don't really focus on that so much. I realized that it's really important to listen to what your body feels, rather than just ignoring the pain that you feel. Kahit maliit lang yung pain, because you never know like what can happen if it gets worse. So I think being more aware also of what you feel entirely, not just physically, but emotionally and mentally. Really, because of this process, made me more aware of all those that I feel. And it's actually a great experience.
It's like taking care of your health and your body in general. It's like a good investment.
Yeah.
And some people don't seem to make it a priority, but it's actually one of the best investments you can do in your life.
Yeah.
Because you don't know how much, like,
you only live once.
Like in the future when you're older, like, it's all gonna, all the bad habits you've been doing,
reflect.
It's going to manifest on that in those ages. So taking care of it now is like a really good investment.